Deuteronomy, chapter 16.
Watch for the moon of green ears of barley, Abib, and sacrifice the Passover to Yahweh your Father. For in the moon of green ears of barley, Yahweh your Father brought you out of Egypt by night. Therefore, you must sacrifice the Passover to Yahweh your Father from the flock and the herd at the place Yahweh chooses to establish his name. You must eat no leavened bread with it, but for 7 days eat unleavened bread, the bread of affliction. For you came out of the land of Egypt in haste, so you may remember the day you set out from the land of Egypt all the days of your life. No leaven shall be seen among you in all your territory for 7 days, nor shall any of the meat you sacrifice on the evening before the first day remain overnight until the morning. You may not sacrifice the Passover within any of your cities Yahweh your Father gives you, but only at the place Yahweh your Father chooses to establish his name. There, you must sacrifice the Passover at... At evening, at the going of the sun, at the season you came out of Egypt, and you shall roast and eat it in the place Yahweh your Father chooses, and in the morning you shall turn and go to your tents. 6 days you must eat unleavened bread, and on the seventh day there shall be a holy convocation to Yahweh your Father. You must do no work. You must count 7 weeks for yourself. Begin to count the 7 weeks from the time you begin to put the sickle to the standing grain. Then you shall observe the Feast of Weeks to Yahweh with a proportion of a freewill offering from your hand, which you will give just as Yahweh blesses you. You shall rejoice in front of Yahweh your Father, you and your wife, wives, your son, your daughter, your manservant, your maidservant, the Levite who lives within your city, the stranger, the fatherless, and the widows among you, at the place Yahweh your Father chooses to establish his name. And you must remember that you were a slave in Egypt, and you must be careful to observe and do these statutes. You must observe the Feast of Tabernacles 7 days after you have gathered from your threshing floor and from your winepress, and you shall rejoice at your feast, you and your wife, wives, your son, your daughter, your manservant, your maidservant, the Levite, the stranger, and the fatherless, and the widows in your cities. 7 days you must keep a joyous feast to Yahweh your Father at the place he will choose, for Yahweh your Father will bless you in all your income and in all the work of your hands, so you will surely have joy. 3 times a year, all your males shall appear in front of Yahweh your Father at the place he will choose, at the Feast of Unleavened Bread, at the Feast of Weeks, and at the Feast of Tabernacles. And they must not appear in front of Yahweh empty-handed. Every man shall give as he is capable of giving, in proportion to the blessing Yahweh your Father has given you. You must appoint judges and officers in all the cities Yahweh your Father gives you, from each of your tribes, and they shall judge the people with righteous judgment. You must not pervert justice. You must not show partiality, nor take a bribe, because a bribe blinds the eyes of the wise and twists the words of the righteous. You must follow justice and only justice so you may live and inherit the land Yahweh your Father is giving you. You must not plant a tree to be used as a sacred pole, Asherah pole, for setting pagan feasts beside the altar which you shall make to Yahweh your Father. And you must also not set up a sacred pillar, image of the sun god, Baal, for these Yahweh your Father hates.